Good morning, dear students. Last day we discussed about that sample and sampling methods. Now we will discuss about briefly sampling methods. I think last class we discussed about only two sampling methods, that is a random and systematic random sample. Then we will continue from that sampling methods. See, as we discussed about sampling design, we discussed about there is a sampling types of methods of sampling methods. So there is a probability sampling method is nothing but known as a random sampling method, and non-probability sampling method is known as a non-random sampling method. So within the random sample or a probability sampling method, there are five types of sampling methods. That is a simple random method, stratifier sampling method, cluster random sampling method, systematic sampling method, and multi-stage random sampling method. And in the non-random sampling methods, there are four types of sampling method: convenient sampling method, judgmental sampling method, quota sampling method, and there is another one is the purposive sampling method also there. So along with that, snowball sampling method. So these are the main types of sampling methods when we are going to collect the information from the respondents. So as the researchers, mainly they can focus on the sampling methods. So it depends on them. They will use a particular sampling method to collect information from the sampling method. Yeah, last day we discussed about that random sampling method. Yeah, random sampling method nothing but if each and every unit of the population has got an equal chance to be selected in the population is called random sampling method. So for example, if you take into account, earlier I have given example. So in the class there are 60 members, there are 60 students. For example, I would like to select a few people. So for example, out of 60, I would like to select a 5 people or 5 students. So how can I select 5 people? So simple, I can follow the random sampling method. Random sampling method. Just a minute, somebody is joining. Yeah. So here, so when we have to list out all the how many students are there in the particular class. So yeah. So for example, I would like to show for example here, see, so for example in a particular class, so this is a classroom. So there are 60 members, total students are 60. Out of 60, I would like to take 5 students. So here, how can I select 5 students? So for example, if I use simple random sampling method, I can list out the guys for serial number, for example, serial number.
ఆర్డర్ వస్తాయి, ఆర్డర్ పోతారు తర్వాత బడి పెడతారు.
సో 1 2 3 4 5 టు లైక్ దట్. సో యాజ్ పర్ సీరియల్ నంబర్ ఐ కెన్ లిస్ట్ అవుట్ ఆల్ ద 62 స్టూడెంట్స్ స్టూడెంట్స్ students. So here simple, I can put all numbers in a particular paper. Simple, I can select anyone from 1 to 60. So I will select only 5 people from 1 to 60. That is called simple randomism, nothing but I will give an order or I will give a chance to everyone to select a sample. For example, 60, for example, if for example the principal is going to ask that, so we can survey 5 people to represent a BA class. Simple. So after that I will come to the class, then I will inform you regarding the particular thing. Then so I will say that, so if anyone interested to represent the class, for example, if I say that, so how many people are interested to represent your class? For example, if 5 people are say that, so simple, I will select the that 5 people or 5 students. That is called simple random method. Here when I say that those who are interested to represent the class, so here what I given the statement, that those who are interested, nothing but here I have given each and every student an equal opportunity to select a represent. That is called random sampling method. Is it clear? That is called a simple random sampling method or random sampling method. Is it clear now? Hello, is it clear now?
Yes sir.
Yeah, then we will go with that next, systematic random sampling method. Systematic random sampling method. The systematic random sample, what it is, systematically we need to select. For example, here systematically, for example, in the random sampling method we have listed 1 2 3 4 dot 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 60. Okay, so here we have given equal opportunity to the all the students. Is it right? Yeah. Then here systematically we need to select a sample. For example, here see, here we did not select systematically. For example, here one number is selected, next this number fellow is selected, this number fellow is selected, this number, and there's some huge gap between the these people. Okay, so here we, in order to maintain a systematical gap between the numbers, that is called serial number or rule numbers. So in that case we need to follow the systematic random sampling method. So here systematic random sampling method, systematic random sampling method. So here first we need to understand how many population are there, nothing but population size. POPN is nothing but here. Population, how many population are there? Then decide sample size, SS, nothing but sample size. So your next third step in that, so divide the population with sample size. Okay, then fourth step here, systematic, select a random number, select a random number from 1 to 60. Here think about sample, total population is 60. Okay, so you select a random number, anyone from 1 to 60. We can select 1 to 60 number, any one number. Then add the this number. For example,
sir, the video is not clear
now. Now hello, now is it clear now?
No sir.
See, so first one we need to discuss, decide population, how many population are there. So we thought about that 60. So decide sample size, nothing but 5. we need to select 5 sample from out of 60, then divide population by sample size. 60 by 5, how much will come? 60 by 5. 12, na?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So select any number from 1 to 60. For example, here, so anyone can say that which is your random number or lucky number? Can anybody say out of 1 to 60?
Eighteen.
So here you have selected random number 18. Okay. So here 18, you add the 12 now. This divide the population by sample size 12. 12 plus 18. Or 18 plus 12. Okay. So here when we are list out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 60. Okay, 60. So here your random number is 18. Na? So here somewhere 18 number is there. This is the first number, first sample. Then you can add this 12 plus, 18 plus 12. How much? 30. Right? Then again, you can add the 30 plus 12, 42. 42 plus 12, how much? 54. Then 54 plus 12, how much? 66. So do you have the 66 rule number here? Can anybody say that? Hello? Sir. See here. Yes. See. So you have selected random number 18. So whatever we got, that divide the population by sample size, one number is will be there, no? 12. So 18 is the first sample, the random sample. Okay, first sample. Then 18 plus 12, we need to add this 12 with 18. The 12 plus 18, how much? 30, the second sample. And nothing but serial number 18 will be select first. Then rule number 30 will be select second sample. Then 30 plus 12, 42. The serial number 42 or rule number 42 will be select as the third sample. Then 42 plus 12, 54 will be select as a fourth sample. Then we need to select 5 sample, no? Here, 5 sample. Okay. So in order to select fifth sample, if we had 54 plus 12, how much? 66. Do we have 66 number in your total population? No. So yes, in that case, we need to come from 1 to numbers. For example, here 60 is a number, this is the last number. Then we need to add 60 plus 6, 6 plus 6. The sixth number will be selected as a fifth sample. Here our sample is, so rule number 18 will be selected as a first sample, 30 will be select, okay, then 42 will be select, 54 will be select, and rule number 6 will be selected. So these are the 5 samples we will select as a systematically. Is it clear now? Hello? Is it audible or
yes,
not?
Sir.
Yeah, is it understandable?
Yes, sir, audible.
Yeah.
Yes, now? Sir.
So if you have any query or in doubt, you can ask me now. Is it clear now? How we can select a sample by using the systematic random sampling method. Clear? For example, I will give you another example also. See, for example, our population is 10. Okay, it is a small class. For example, if you think the small class law, so there are 10 students are there, but we need to select sample size is 3. Okay, so what is the third step in the, we need to divide population by sample size, that is the 10 by 3 is equal to how much? 3.3. so 3.3 is more or less equal to 3, right? So here we need to select a random number from 1 to 10. Can anybody say which is a lucky number from 1 to 10? 5. Okay, good. So, yeah, see here the population is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is the population. Huh? So, randomly one person has selected 5th. Okay, this is the first sample amount. Then we need to add this 3 with 5. 5 plus 3, how much? 8. This is the second sample. Then 8 plus 3. How much will come? 8 plus 3? 11. Do we have the 11 here? 11. No. Okay.
11, sir.
So 11 number is not here in our class. Okay. Then we will come from 10 to 1. This is. Okay. Is it clear now? Here your sample size is 1, serial number 1 will be selected, serial number 5 will be selected, serial number 8 will be selected. Out of 10 sample lo 10 students untaru anko andulo 3 members select cheskovali anukunte manam em cheskunnamante system ni random anukoni manam oka random sample number etkunna tarvata select cheskunna tarvata aa 3 ki diniki add chesam 5 plus 3 8 8 plus 3 11 11 aithe endante 1 2 3 so ee number anedi select aitundi systematically ga we will select a number clear see here see this is the same graphical representation. For example, if you select a random number 3, so if you had 3 plus 3, 6. Serial number 6 will be selected. If you selected 6 plus 3, 9 number. This is systematical. The gap should be same. Gap should be same. Is it clear now? Hello, student.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So if you have that doubt clarification at the end of the 5 minutes, so we will discuss briefly. So if you have any doubt, and you can write it, you can write down, then you will ask me at the end of the session. Clear? Yeah. Third one is a stratified random sampling method. Stratified random sampling method. See here, stratified random sampling method is nothing but a population which have that there are different combinations. For example, the population are the heterogeneous, not homogeneous. When we see in the market perception or in the market classification of markets, we have that perfect competition, imperfect competition, right? Within the imperfect competition, we have the monopoly, duopoly, oligopoly, right? The perfect competition, monopolistic competition also. So here the samples, they have the different characteristics. Different characteristics. For example, in the last method, there is a systematic and simple random method. Somebody has said that which have that rule number 1, 5, 8, they may be female only. For example, if I say that Tara asked that, nah? So you need to send the 5 students to represent the BA class. For example, if I follow this method, that is a systematic random method, rule number 1, rule number 5, and rule number 8. If they are female, for example, yoka mood serial number ane vallu female ur ankonde, what the male people, that the male students will think about? See, sir, so they will think that sir is biased. Is it right or wrong? Because sir has given more priority to the girls, not prior to the boys, right? So here, in order to select, represent from male background and female background, then I am going to stratify on the different strata or different characteristics. So that is called stratified random sampling method. It means that population is divided into two or more groups, all called strata. For example, in the class, you have male and female, or boys and girls. If I select boys only, girls will think that sir is biased. If I select girls, boys will think about that sir is biased. So in order to select from female and male, then firstly I will classify it into two groups, that is a male and female. Is it clear now? That is called stratified random sampling method. Simple stratified random sampling method. Convert or divide the sample on the base of their characteristics. Characteristics. Okay. For example, if you take anything, for example, farmers. Okay. The farmers, they have that, there is some classification. So here in the farmers community, we have that marginal farmers, small farmers, medium farmers, and large farmers. For example, when you collect information with regard to the farmer suicides. For example, if I collect only information with regard to the small farmers, do you think that only small farmers are committed suicide? No. So we need to collect information from the all the classification on all the farmers. So we need to select a small farmers, we need to select a marginal farmers, we need to select a medium farmers, we need to select a large farmers. Then only the outcome, the results will represent the actual thing. So here, if I want to show that, I will show again. See here, for example, in a class, okay, so this is a boys, this is a girls row, for example, if I say, so boys are 40, girls are 40, okay, so here, I need, in order to send a 5 represent or 5 students to the principal office, so I need to select 3 members from boys, 2 members from girls, okay, so here, first we, what we have done, so we need to classify it on the basis of strata, boys and girls, girls and boys. That is a strata. Clear? See that when we are collecting information about the particular thing, nothing but here, when you are doing the market perception, see here, in order to know a quality of the brand or quality of the commodity, what we have to do, we need to select information from the customers. We need to collect some information with regard to the wholesaler, retailers, and we need to collect information those who are involved in the marketing agencies, marketing field. So here we need to collect information from the different disciplines or different strata. So why we can take this type of types of information from the different people? So in order to represent of all groups in a sample population, all population. For example, I am going to give another example for you that farmers. For example, in order to know that in the socio-economic conditions. So if the government is allotted a project to you, for example, that is called socio-economic conditions of the farmers in Telangana state, socio-economic condition. Nothing but what are the problems of economic situation, nothing but crop gani, pantal gani, nastal gani, labal gani. So we need to estimate their expenditure, revenue, how much they are spending, how many hours they are spending, what is the labor charge. And here, the labor charge is different from type of farmer to another type of farmer. Nothing but small farmer labor charge is different from large farmers. For example, if you take that cultivation charges for the tractors, for example, you can take. So fertilizer charges to the large farmers and small farmers, there is a difference. For example, here, at the same time, when we are collecting information with regard to the farmers, so here, marginal farmers, small farmers, medium farmers, large farmers. Okay. So when we are collecting information from the different groups, then we will come to know the conclusion that on average, how much the farmers are spending some amount of money on the particular crop. So when they will ask that, so is there any difference between small farmers and large farmers expenditure? Then we will ready to defend that question that, so there is a huge variance, different huge variance between that small farmers and large farmers expenditure, right? So in order to study that particular things, or in order to represent all the groups in a sample population, we will select a So we will follow the stratifier random sampling method. Stratifier random sampling method. So I am giving a so here stratifier random sampling method is also known as a classified random sampling method. Classified random sampling method. So you can note down that stratifier random sampling method is known as classified random sampling method. Classified random sampling method. Clear? So do you have any doubt with regard to that stratified and systematic random sampling method? Hello, dear students. Hello?
No, sir.
No. So have you understood this random sampling, stratified random sampling method? So or else I will give you another example that when you take into account, when you read the newspapers, you may get some classified papers, nothing but the heading is classified. Have you seen anyone classified? So majorly if you take a DC paper or in the district papers, they will give the, some classifieds, some advertisements. So when you observe that thing that they will ask that vadhu kavalanu, varudu kavalanu, aya kavalanu, pani manchi kavalanu. Have you heard about anyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, there is the one agency which will collect information from different parts. Nothing but, for example, any agency. For example, Anil agency. For example, Anil is going to establish an agency that is called Anil agency. He will collect information or he will give the information to the public. So here he got some information with regard to the vadhu kavalanu, varudu kavalanu, aya kavalanu, lecturers kavalanu, teachers kavalanu antadu manaku newspaper lalo. Have you seen or can I show that?
We know about that.
Yeah. So here, so there are classification. So here each and every, nothing but when you see the classification newspaper classification ads in the newspaper, simple vadhu kavalanu ane daggana vadhu kavalanu list out untadi oka 10 members gaani 5 members gaani. So if there is a wanted lecturers, for example, so in which college there are some vacancies, they will display in the particular wanted lecturers column only. Okay, so they will collect a huge information. If one agency, they will collect a huge information and they will classify on the different strata. Ante oka teachers kavalana vallo oka daggarne isaru, teachers lecturers kavalana vallo oka daggarne isaru, aya kavalana vallo oka list out oka column isaru, vadu kavalana vallo oka list isaru, varudu kavalana oka list isaru. That is the classifications. Okay, so that is called stratified random sampling method. Stratified random sampling method is also known as classified random sampling method. This is a very important question. Sometimes they will ask in the research orientation or MPhil or PG entrance or PhD entrance, any exams. They will ask that stratified random sampling method is also known as classified random sampling method. Okay. Then another one is the fourth one, cluster random sampling method. Cluster random sampling method. For example, here cluster is nothing but, so the population is divided into the subgroups. Clusters like families, like a small family, big family. That is called cluster. So what are the expenditure incurred by the, or what is the expenditure of small farmers? What is the expenditure of large So what is the expenditure of small small family and what is the expenditure of big family? That is a large number of people which they will live together. There is a small family or big family. So that is the population divided into the subgroups like families. So another example I will going to give that singer any calorie. For example, if you want to know that what are the economical conditions of singer any employees in Telangana state, the singer and belt is in Kottagudem, nothing but Khammam, and somewhere in Karimnagar. For example, here their expenditure is different from Khammam. Singareni employees expenditure different from Karimnagar Singareni implies expenditure. Yeah, their problems are different from their problem. Nothing but Khammam Singareni implies problems are different from Karimnagar Singareni implies problem. Some are similar, but some are different. So here we need to divide a group. That is, the Singareni is a one society. So within the society, we will divide the subgroups. That is called Singareni. Karimnagar Singareni implies and Khammam Singareni implies. That is called group, subgroup. And here, after dividing the subgroups, we will select a random sample from each cluster. Each cluster, nothing but. So here, see, if you take an example, this is a village. For example, if you think, these are small families. This is a small families. We have divided the pots. Or if you take this a village, for example, within the village also, we will divide the areas, developed area, not developed area. Or if you take in Hyderabad, best example I'm going to give, the slum areas and other areas. See, so within this, if you think this is Hyderabad, so this part is a small, that is a slum area. This part also slum areas. See here, the slum areas people are getting different problems compared with the other people, right or wrong? So in order to study that, what are the problems are faced by Hyderabadis, but Hyderabadis problems are together is different. When you divide subgroups, so the slum area people's problems are different from other area people's problem. That is called cluster sampling method. So when you do some research only, you will come to know easily, but you are a beginners. So you may understand easily also, but some are different. When you are involved in the research only, you will get more idea and you will get easy understand also. So this is a example of the cluster analysis. Is it clear or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Today we will stop here. Then tomorrow we will continue from that multi-stage random sampling method. Okay, then if you have any doubts and with regard to that sample and sampling, sampling, sample, population, and these types of sampling methods, if you have any doubts, and you can ask me now. We have the 2.5 minutes and we will discuss. So anybody have doubts, please ask me. You can unmute your voice and you will ask me.
Sir, notes, I want notes about this topic so that we can understand more betterly, sir.
Achha. I had the file, but yeah, today I will send this. This is a I had file. This is prepared for the PG course only. So I will send today, which you can easily understand also by reading this concept. Okay, no problem. I will send now after completion of the class only. I will send by the 11 or 10:50.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Another people, anyone have the doubts or clarification if you need, and then.
No, sir.
No. So there's some. Have you understood or not? That is the first point. Then if you have understood only, it is okay. But if you don't have understand only, you may not ask any questions also. That is the one thing. Is class is clear now?